Gist, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally.
Duly noted.
On your mark, Captain!
St. Lawrence.
Then on to Quebec and Montreal. The tide is turning.
General Wolfe will give that crazy old calm a right thrashing.
Do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. Such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Duly noted.
I've heard Louisbourg could be a linchpin in the war. If the Royal Navy can take that port, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
Then on to Quebec and Montreal. The tide is turning.
General Wolfe will give that craven Montcalm a right thrashing.
I've been looking forward to that since Fort William Henry.
With this this bloody war over, we'll finally bring order to this damn continent.
Ready, Captain! Order's there!
Thank you.
She'll be a fine
close
ship.
Down! Catch some wind! Fire! And trip two!
Ready, Captain!
Loose all and trip sharp in the wind!
Cannon ready!
Fire!
Yeah.
Unfurl, maids! Let's move!
Spread those sheets!
You're not playing ducks and drakes with that!
Proud on every inch of sail!
As we were fishing,
loose capsules,
gallants and royals!
Shoot! Then pulling and trolling all night in that windy old weather, stormy old weather, when the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
When up jumped a herring, the queen of the sea, says now, old skipper, you cannot catch me.
In the windy old weather, stormy old weather, when the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
He sighted a thrasher, slashing his tail.
Floating cargo for the taking, sir.
Old skipper, hoist up your sail.
In the windy old weather, stormy old weather, when the wind blows, we'll all pull together.
Then up jumps a slipsail as strong as a horse.
There she is, the HMS Pembroke, Captain James Cook's ship.
She's a beauty.
Man o' war, fully armed. We should bring the Morrigan alongside. Master Kenway will surely be waiting.
Guest, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid at Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.